Right, all of you will come for the seminar series, Management Accounting. Right, this is the basic stage of the Management Accounting filler after completion of the Business Mathematics and Statistics. But I think you already exempted from that subject. Right, first I will explain what is the structure of the paper. That is very important. You can have only 2 hour paper. Right, only 2 hour paper, including 50 questions to answer within 2 hours. Each and every question have 2 marks. The important thing, all these 50 questions are MCQ questions. Some questions may be MCQ, you have to select the answer, but some questions you have to write down the answer on the box given, or you have to drag the correct answer from the given answers. You will have a box, you have to drag the correct answer into that box, or you have to just write down the or type the correct answer on the given box, or you have to select the answer. However, we have 50 questions within 2 hours. That is the structure. I think you already aware about the syllabus. This is the costing, that is including management account costing within the management accounting pillar. If I take, first I will explain the syllabus. This is the syllabus content. You have introduction to management accounting, then cost classification, labor costing, overhead costing, pricing, integrated accounting, job costing, batch costing, contract and service costing, process costing, marginal costing and absorption costing. This is a major part of your syllabus. Thereafter you have the standard costing and variance analysis, then you have short term and long term decision making. Finally, you have, even it's called working capital management, actually we have only the inventory management part, right? The, if you refer the weightages given, you can see the first part have 35% marks, the second part planning and controlling 20%, decision making 25%, risk and uncertainty 10%, working capital management 10%. That's how the syllabus consists. Now I will tell you how I am going to conduct this process, conduct this series over these 10 days. You know the 10 days, 2 hours per day, maximum we have only 20 hours. That is not enough to cover the entire syllabus. What I am going to do now, I will explain all the major areas of the syllabus. I am not going to use separate presentations for the theoretical parts, because it is useless to use the, because you have, finally you have multiple choice questions at the paper. I have prepared separate MCQ question list to discuss with you. It will be presented through the PowerPoint presentation. However, before moving to that part, I will explain the major areas of the syllabus, not the all the areas, not the page by page in the study text. The important areas in the each chapter, I will explain first, right? Thereafter, I will take that selected multiple choice questions to discuss with you, because I can conduct the lectures, but this is little bit different. Even you read the study text twice or thrice a time, but you have to answer MCQ question. You believe, I think you feel it is easy, but not it is easy. This is the difficult exam, because you have to select the correct answer. No answers for the steps. If examiner asks you to calculate the break-even point, if it is a essay type question, you can write down the formula and you can allocate figures to the formula and you can arrive the answer. You have 3 steps. Even last answer you given is wrong, you will receive marks at least half for the other steps. Now here you don't have that chance. You have to select the correct answer. You have to know that is 100%. Therefore, my process is, I will explain the not all the topics, the important topics you need to learn, because most of the areas already you covered in AAT or A level. For an example, labor costing, overhead costing, you covered in your A level or AAT. Therefore, I will focus for the most important areas. Thereafter, I will take for each and every area the MCQ question list. Right? Today, I am going to discuss especially the chapter 1 and chapter 2, that is introduction to management accounting and cost classification. I am trying to cover this area, because these two chapters, you think that is the first 2 chapters not important, but this is the most important chapter for you, because all the fundamentals given here for the management accounting. Therefore, these 2 chapters are very important, especially in your paper. First 5 to 6 questions may be from these two chapters, right? I have prepared a question list. Actually, I have extracted from other professional exams, especially CIMA, ACC exams. I have selected these MCQ questions. I will discuss these questions with you. I will show you how that questions can be tested in the exam. Right. Now, these are MCQ type questions, right? As well as you can have this type of questions. That is, you will be given a small case. Thereafter, based on the case, you will be asked 2-3 questions, right? Then some figures will be given. Then based on the figures, you have to calculate. For an example here, you have been given figures. What is the direct wage cost for the department 1 for the month of June? Then direct wage cost, you have to calculate using the calculator. Then your answer, you have to select here. That type of question you have to face at the exam. Not only that, this type of questions. See, the which of the following items, might item or items both, might be not. Item or items means you may have only one answer or more than one answer, right? Might be a suitable cost unit within the credit control department of the company. What is the suitable cost unit? Right? Then you may have to select one, or sometimes you have to select all three, or sometimes you have to select three. Clear? Because they are asking item or items. Now, this is not a multiple choice question. That's what I told you, right? This is not a MCQ question. You have to select the answer on the box. Then look this question. The following information is available for product Z for the month of January. The total production cost of producing 8,000 units of products in January. What is the value? That means you will calculate and you have to write down the answer here. Especially this time, because this time exam going to be conduct without the computerized environment. Next exam, I believe examination division going to computerize. Therefore, next exam onward, that is September 2020 exam onwards, you will have computer-based exam. Then you have to type the answer on that box. But here you have to write down on the paper, they will be given, right? That's how that paper can be set. I have included many questions, right? Let's discuss. But before discuss these questions, what we need to do, we have to identify the major areas in the syllabus, right, which is important for the learning purposes, right? I will start from the chapter 1. Here, these are the areas in the chapter 1. Definition of management accounting, nature of management accounting information, objective and scope of management accounting, policies and plans to achieve desired objectives, and level of planning and controlling. I think this is a very familiar area for you. Therefore, the areas within this chapter, you can just read and understand. Clear? Therefore, I will take the chapter 2. Cost classification. Basically, cost classification means the cost incurred by the entity, how you can classify. The financial statement is one method of classifying cost. How financial statement classifying the company's cost? Initially, they recognize cost of sale. Clear? Then, administration cost. Then, distribution cost. Other operating cost and finance cost. These are the cost classification of the financial account. How they have classified it? Based on the functions. Sale, cost of sale. Sale is a function. Administration cost. Administration is a function. Distribution cost. Those classified based on function. It's a one method of classifying. Right? When it's come to the management accounting, we have another many methods classifying the cost. Right? Now, same cost, finally, the total cost total value of the total cost will be same in each classification. We are just classifying according to different bases, right? If you take a one method in management accounting, direct cost and indirect cost, right? That's a one method of classifying. Direct cost means you will recognize cost directly incurred on the production. Clear? That's the direct cost. The cost will vary with the number of units. That's the direct cost. Cost will not vary with the number of units, we call fixed cost. That's a one method, right? Likewise, you can have different method of prime cost and overhead cost. Clear? Prime cost and overhead cost. And different methods we have. Let's see what are the methods that study text given us. The number one, as I told you, direct cost and indirect cost. I'm not going to explain one by one in this study text, right? I will just highlight the areas you need to aware. Then let's move into the questions, right? Direct cost. Now, how this can be identified? Basically, cost will identified by the nature, basically. That is material cost, labor cost, other direct cost and other indirect cost. Within this, you have cost incurred directly with the item and directly with the time. Now, rent of a business is a cost incurred with the time, not with the units you produce or sell. Clear? That's the classification. Cost can be directly identified with the units, is a direct cost. But one thing you need to understand, right? Better to have short notes if you want. When you classifying cost as direct and indirect, right? The direct cost means cost will vary with the number of units you produce. Clear? That's the direct cost. Indirect cost means cost not vary with the number of units you produce. However, see this example. We have a small building. We are selling breads here. We are selling breads. Clear? Now you need to buy breads. Therefore, purchase cost of a bread is a direct cost, because when you buy 2, it will be double. When you buy 100, it will be multiplied by 100. Therefore, purchase cost of bread, it's a direct cost. Clear? The rent you pay for this building, rent for this building is an indirect cost. Clear? Because that is not depend on the units. Clear? We are calling fixed cost also. But the problem is, if you want to expand your business, if you need to sell more breads than today, you have to have another additional room, additional building. That means you have to rent another additional building adjoined to your business. Then your rent will be double. Assume, using this building, you can sell maximum 1,000 breads. But if you want to sell 1,001 bread, you cannot utilize this building. You have to have another building. Therefore, when the units until up to 1,000, rent will remain constant. But when the units increase more than 1,000, rent will double. Is that clear? Therefore, that fixed cost we are talking, right, will fixed within the capacity. If you are exceeding your capacity, fixed cost is starting to vary. That's an important point to understand. Clear? I'm just explaining these points, right? This is a basic information given about the cost. Now, the cost category, direct materials, that depend on the components, right? The direct labor, that is only assembly, how many labor hours, that depend on the how many labor hours. Direct expenses like when you producing breads, wheat flour is a direct material, right? Person who worked there, direct labor. You have to pack this bread and sell. You have to at least fix your labels. Is that clear? At least you have to use small bags to pack it. That packing cost. It is not included within the bread, but to sell the bread, you need to do that. Those are the other direct cost. If you produce in furniture, right? The timber is the direct material involved in there, but you have to polish it, right? You have to use some chemicals to protect those timber. Also direct other cost, right? Then that's total direct material, direct labor and direct expenses, other direct expenses. Totally called prime cost, that is total direct cost of production. Can you remember the manufacturing account we learn in financial accounting? Direct material, direct labor, other direct cost, total called prime cost. Therefore, total prime cost or total direct cost is the same. Then you have production overhead. Production overhead, again you have variable and fixed. What is variable production overhead? Generally, overhead expenses. Do you know the difference between that overhead expense now? Overhead also can be classified as variable and fixed. Clear? But there is a difference between this direct material and the overhead. What's the main difference? What is the difference? Now, the example given, machine running cost. Machine will operate during the production phases, production time, production period. Therefore, machine running cost vary with the number of units you produce. Is that clear? Machine running cost will be vary with the number of units you will produce. Therefore, it's a direct cost, but it's called overhead, variable overhead. All these three are also variable cost, variable and fixed, direct and indirect, clear? But why this machine running cost is a variable cost, direct cost, but separately identifying? Because machine running cost not a part of the final production. Is that clear? To produce the bread, we need wheat flour, labor, and the packing material. Machine running cost indirectly influences to the production, varying with the number of units. Therefore, variable overhead we separately identifying as variable production overhead and fixed production overhead. Now, machine running cost, machine will be operate within the production period, but factory canteen or production director's salary, even produced or not, canteen will be open, director will be worked. Is that clear? Therefore, that production director's salary or the canteen cost is a fixed overhead. Clear? Then you have the total direct and indirect cost of production. From this point to this, you have all production cost. Thereafter, company will incur non-production cost, such as administration distribution. That also can be identified as variable and fixed. Now, when you are using a motor vehicle, right, the motor vehicle insurance cost is a fixed overhead for distribution. But fuel expenses will depend on the number of units you will distribute. Is that clear? Therefore, fuel on distribution vehicles, distribution variable overhead. the insurance certificate cost, insurance certificate cost is a fixed cost on the vehicle, distribution vehicle, right? That's a basic classification. You have been given examples here, and the overhead explained, the non-production overhead explained. I am not going to read those things, right? But I will take some examples given in the study text before moving to the MCQ question list. The direct labor employees wage in week 5 consists of following. Direct labor employees wage. Direct labor employees means those who are directly involved in the production process. Is that clear? For the week 5, basic pay, basic salary, for normal hours worked, 36 hours, 400 rupees per hour, therefore 14,400. Pay at the basic rate for overtime, that overtime rate, they have worked 6 hours, 400 rupees, 2,400. Overtime shift premium, because general hour they will receive 400, therefore they should have a premium for overtime. That premium is 400 rupees. Look at the overtime shift premium with overtime paid at time and a quarter. That means additional hour will pay additional 100 rupees. General hour will pay 400 rupees. Additional hour pay additional 100 rupees. That's why you take 1/4. Clear? Generally, you can say, you can take this together. How? 6 hours into 500 rupees. Or you can take general value this, premium value is this. Right? Now, here total is 3000, right? Then see, 6 hours into 500, because I told you, additional hour will pay additional 100 rupees, 1/4 of the general rate. That 1/4 is 100 rupees. Therefore, OT hour will be 500 rupees, then 6 into 500, 3000. They have calculated separately. Is that clear? A bonus payment under group bonus scheme, bonus for the month. That bonus payment under group bonus scheme, right? 3000. As a group, they are getting this bonus 3000. Total wage cost in the week 5. 20,400 for 42 hours. Why? General hours work 36, additional hours works 6. Altogether, do you have worked 42 hours? Entire 42 hours for the week, they paid 20,400 cost. Now, see the question raised. Required, calculate the direct labor cost for this employee in week 5. Direct labor cost. Which one directly change with the production and which one not directly change with the production? Is that clear? Do you have the calculators? No. Better to bring the calculators to the tomorrow onwards, because this paper is a MCQ question, short question paper. 50 questions you have, right? 50 questions you have. During the 2 hours period, you have to use your calculator and see the answer and select the given list. No huge calculation, no huge paper booklets to use. You will be given the paper, select the answers. While you selecting, you have to do more calculations. If you can use your brain or the additional brains you have purchased from the cart shops, the calculator, the additional brain you have. Now people have 2 brains, your own brain and the calculator. Therefore, you have to practice your brain and calculator during the exam, right? Because you are going to be a new student with this paradigm shift, both level 1 and level 2 totally MCQ, the short questions, right? Okay, just calculate the answer. They are asking the direct cost. What is the direct cost? The direct cost is the cost varied with the units. Here, what is the unit we measure? Number of hours worked. Clear? Okay. Calculate the direct labor cost for these employees in week 5. You have only four cost. Basic payments for 36 hours at 400 rupees. Then overtime at the normal rate and overtime with the premium. Right? Then the bonus. Bonus payment under group bonus scheme. So group bonus scheme. Right? They received 3000. Now, what is the cost that company paid? Right? Based on the number of hours. Can I ask one question from you? Please raise those who are already participating for classes, because all these students doing going classes, right? You are not going classes. You? Sorry? You? Not self studies. You are going classes. Sorry? Self studies. Did you participate KE2 subject in last September? All of you? You are the luckiest people in the world, because you have been exempted from the mathematics and the statistics. Very nice. Nice to see you. Because we assume, not me, CS Sri Lanka assumed, since you have participated for this paper, you are the genius in mathematics. Right? But you know, that KE2 paper is just like a multi-barrel attack with an atom bomb. Right? එක පැත්තකින් මල්ටි බැරල් ගහද්දී අනිත් පැත්තෙන් පරමාණු බෝම්බෙකුත් ගන්න. නේ? කියන්නේ එක පැත්තෙන් ගන්නකොට අනිත් පැත්තට දුවත හැකිනේ. ඒ පැත්තෙනුත් ගන්න. දෙපැත්තෙන්ම ගන්නකොට යන තැන නෑ. ඒ වෙලාවට අපි කියන්නේ මොකද සාමාන්‍ය සිංහලෙන්? ලොවෙත් නැති වෙලාවක් කියලා. මොකද ලොවෙත් නැති වෙලා හිටිය අවුරුදු පහක් නේ. හරියට හරි. දැන් එකක් අයින් කරා. මොකද අයින් කරේ? Maths, you have been exempted. Now you are being happy, but don't enjoy much. I will show you. Because the end of this chapter, you have regression analysis. You have to use that. You have a separate part, cost estimation using different techniques. I did this chapter last week for the business mathematics and statistics students. If you have a chance, please watch that video. Cost estimation. Right? The maths amatak karala meke yanda ba puthiya. Because costing or management accounting is preparation of financial figures and non-financial figures for the management for their decision making activities. Whatever the report will be presented as a manager through numbers which was arrived after analysis or computations or as essay type presentations. ඉත මොක කරන්නත් අකුරු ලියන්න පුළුවන් වෙලා තියෙන්න ඕන ගණන් හදන්න පුළුවන් වෙලා තියෙන්න බෑ. මොකද ලෝකේ ඕනම දෙයක් එක්ක ඉලක්කම් වලින් කියනවා නැත්තම් you will tell it in words. Now this end of this chapter, I think you already experienced. You have regression. Then maths නෑ මාරයි නියමයි. නෑ regression තියෙනවා. තව චුට්ටක් යහට යද්දි no financial mathematics නෑ. Time value of money නෑ. දැන් ඔය annuity, perpetuity, present value, future value නෑ. නෑ නෙමෙයි තියෙනවා. Why? Here we are talking how we can apply those techniques in mathematics and statistics for decision making in management accounting. Right? One example, you taught, you learned Pythagoras theorem in O level, right? Grade 5, 6, 7. Am I correct? But not that practically applied. Am I correct? Anybody can raise your hands? Those who have applied Pythagoras theorem practically? No. Why? But in the village, the mason bars, daily applying that theory. You did not apply it. Clear? But one day you have to apply. Therefore, don't erase that memory. You may worked hard for that atom bomb plus multi-barrel attack. Therefore, you already have the knowledge. You cannot erase it, right? You have to use it. Since mathematics, statistics and the costing together, it was an easy paper, I think. Now, directly you have only the filtered part of the costing included within the management accounting. Now you are directly considering about the decision making using the techniques, right? Therefore, don't ignore anything. If you have a chance, download the study text for mathematics and statistics, right? Try to just read it to have an idea. Clear? Right. Now here, what is the answer? 14,400 only the basic salary, or 16,800 the basic salary and the basic payment for OT, or 19,800, what is 19,800 without premium paid for OT balance? 14,400, 2,400 and 3,000, or 20,400 total. What will be the direct labor cost? Right? Simply, here you can find out here's answer B. But look this study text, you have half of each explanation why that answer arrived. That's the point you need to learn. Somebody will tell you, okay, answer B. The answer B. Now just see the question. Mangina menna pute, a nice question. Answer is B. Now what you have learned? You learn 16,800 is the answer for this question. If you learn like this, you will answer only this type of question at the exam. But you must learn not to answer this type of question in the exam. You must learn the rationale behind that. Why 16,800 arised? Then you can answer any question at the exam. Once you learn the rationale. Is that clear? Always try to understand what is the rationale behind the answers. Try to grab that rationale. Okay, let's see why they have taken 16,800. 16,800 is only these two. The basic salary paid for 36 hours and the basic payment for the OT hours. What they dropped? Premium paid for the OT hours and the bonus. No doubt here, easily you can say this is not a direct cost, right? Why? It's a bonus scheme as a group. I will give you a bonus. Each person 1,000 rupees. Even if you work or not, you will receive the bonus. As you receive the bonus for mathematics and statistics in the new syllabus. Okay? That's why it is not a variable thing. Why? You may work hard 6 months and fail KE2. You may not work at least 6 hours, but you also failed it. Right? Different student may work different times, but finally what happened? Everybody got exempt. Then what happened? Is it variable thing based on your work hours, working hours? No. Is that clear? That type of bonus given here. But why they have dropped the premium paid for salary? The premium paid on the OT 6 hours. Why they have dropped it? That is the important point to understand. They just took the direct basic salary and the basic salary for the OT hours. Ignore the premium. If somebody tell you, okay, OT hour will pay 500 rupees, but entire 500 rupees is not the direct part. Only the basic part within the 500 is the direct part. Premium paid for the OT, not the direct cost. Why? What is the normal rate per hour? 400 rupees. Why they are paying 500 rupees? Why they are paying 500 rupees? Since you are not complete the work within the given period of time, right? Therefore, you have used additional 6 hours to the work, right? Why they have 500? Since people committed to work after the working period, this 600 goes since they have work in night or morning. Is that clear? Correct what I am telling? 400 is the standard rate per hour. 500 paid since you committed to work more than 8 hours. Is that clear? Therefore, that 100 rupees not paid for the production, that 100 rupees paid for your commitment, your willingness to complete the work. You love for the company, that is why you work more hours. That 100 goes for that. Then it is not, it is not a direct cost with the product. Is that clear? That is why we are dropping it. Good. That is the point you need to understand. That you must learn. That is why we are not dropping the premium portion within the OT hours. Is that clear? පැහැදිලිද කියන ඒවා ප්‍රශ්නේ තියෙන රෂනල් එක ඩෙන්ටිෆයි කරන්න try to understand the rational behind that, right? The correct answer is premium. They have explained the reasons to drop the bonus. Generally you can easily understand bonus is not a given based on the number of units, but sometimes bonus will be paid on the number of units, but here is a group bonus, right? The premium also dropped. Why? Premium paid due to the employee's commitment, not due to the production made. Clear? Here I have told you the financial accounting allocating cost based on the function, cost of sale, administration cost, distribution cost, finance cost, other operating cost. That classification is here, right? Based on the function, you are classifying. Now, let us see this question. Within the costing system of a manufacturing company, the following types of expenses are incurred. These are the expenses incurred. Right, you have 16 expenses. Now we can understand whether we can identify the different cost. Identify correct cost classification of the above expenses and state the reference number of the expenditure item in the following table. Cost classification. How the cost classification taken? Production cost, selling and distribution cost, administration cost, research and development cost. This is focus in financial accounting. Financial accounting classifying cost like this. Therefore, I think this is very easy for you because you always prepare in P&L and balance sheet. No, you are not preparing P&L, this statement of comprehensive income. That this just like the Simon instead of Simeon, Mr. James instead of James, right? A bun instead of bunnies, a bus instead of busseka, because we have customized to Sri Lanka. This only just changing the name, right? Okay. However, when you prepare in the P&L and balance sheet, you are using this classification. Just see what are the expenses. Cost of, what are the categories given? Production, selling, distribution, administration and research. Okay, easy. Number one, cost of oils used to lubricate production machinery. That is maintenance of production machineries. What is it? Production cost, production overhead. Motor vehicles license for lorries. Lorry will not be used to production or administration, it will be used for distribution. Depreciation of factory plant and equipment, production. Cost of chemicals used in the laboratory, laboratory will be used to distribution or administration or production, no, for research, it's a research cost. Commission paid to sales representative, sales and distribution. Salary of the secretary of the finance director, administration. Trade discount given to customers, sales and distribution. Holiday pay of machine operators, production cost. Salary of security guard in raw material warehouse. අන්තිම කියල නැත්තම් කියන්න පුළුවන්නේ ඌ ඉන්න තැන තමයි අවුලනේ එහෙම හිතනව නේද මිනිහා හොඳයි ඉන්න තැන අවුල නේද salary of security guard in raw material warehouse yeah little bit confusing am I correct what is the way out I will show you look here This is focus in the financial accounting classification, right? In financial accounting classification, first of all, you will prepare production account, manufacturing account. Am I correct? Manufacturing account. Raise who did A level in English medium? You. All of you are doing manufacturing account, right? Tamil medium and single medium. Nishpadana kinu mahaduwa ne? But you mentioned that account, manufacturing account. You have a separate name in Tamil medium? No. You did in Tamil medium? Single? Tamil. You have a separate name for that, right? You know, when I don't know what is the Tamil word for that. Actually, it is difficult to find out. Right? You have separate wordings, right? For manufacturing account, right? You prepared it, right? Thereafter, you have transferred total manufacturing cost into the trade account. Then you calculated cost of? Sale. Then you arrive at the gross profit, goes to the P&L and you deducted administration, distribution and other operating cost and finance cost to arrive at the profit before tax. Correct? Okay. Let's take the manufacturing account. Manufacturing account brings all the manufacturing costs, right? Okay. Started with open raw material plus tell me. Raw material, purchase, carried, inverse, return, everything is there, right? Drawings also there, right? Then minus closing raw material. This answer called direct material cost. Then you have taken direct labor cost, direct other cost. The total called prime cost, direct cost, clear? When relating to material, especially inventory, raw material inventory, inventory cost consists what? Raw material purchase, discount and rebates received will reduce, clear? Carriage inwards, handling cost, the taxes paid, everything, clear? That's include raw material cost, am I correct? The labor cost, direct labor cost, those who involved in the production process, cost paid to the person involved in the production process, direct other cost, the cost used for the production directly other than direct material and labor. Right. Now our question, if I take the question again here, salary of security guard in raw material. Now believe OC, whether you are going to place the salary cost here. After this, you will add variable and fixed production manufacturing overhead, right? You will add variable and fixed manufacturing overhead. Karmanta sala podukar. Right? Then you have the production cost after adjusting work in progress, opening and closing. Right? Okay. Now see, are you going to place the security guard cost who work in the warehouse in the manufacturing account? If yes, that's a production cost. If no, maybe administration or distribution or whatever. That's how you have to decide it. You cannot cram and classify within your mind. Then mole computer ABCD kela, you will partition. Even the mole partition kala va daagande pa. At that time you have to think. Mole kiyanne avayavayak ne. Eken karanne hitana ekane. Neida? Gabada karana eka neme. Api mokada karanne? Api ithan inne mole kiyanne aamaase wage ekak kiyala. Bat kala kala bade gabada karanawane bat. Hari? Api kaya mehema dakkama kaagena kaagena ne aayi mewa labenne nathi kiyala gabada karagena bade. ඒ වගේ මොලේ ගබඩා කරන්න ඉඩක් නැහැ පුතේ. මොලේ තියෙන හිතන්න මිසක් ගබඩා කරන්න නෙමෙයි. ආමාශය තියෙන ගබඩා කරන්න මිසක් හිතන්න නෙමෙයි. පිංගානේ තියෙන ඒවා ආමාශය ගබඩා කරලා පොතේ තියෙන ඒවා මොලේ ගබඩා කරන්න එපා. ඇයි? මොලේ ඒවා ගබඩා කරන්න පුළුවන් පුතේ පොත් ගහන්න ඕනේ නැහනේ. නේ? සර්වර්ස් ඕනේ නැහනේ වෙබ්සයිට් වල දාලා තියන්න. මේ සුතීරණයක් ගන්න ඔක්කොම එකතු වෙලා මුළු ලෝකෙම එක්සත් ජාතීන්ගේ සංවිධානය මිනිසුන්ට මේ සියල්ල මොලේ තියාගන්න පුළුවන් cloud එකක්වත් server එකක්වත් ඕනේ නැහැ කොළ ඕනෙත් නැහැ. ඒ හිඳ මොලේ තියෙන මේවා ගබඩා කරන්න නෙවෙයි නේද? මම දන්නවා මේ කියන්නේ. ඔයාලා මේ ලිස්ට් එක පාඩම් කරනව නැත්තම්. පාඩම් කරනවනේ. නැද්ද? පාඩම් කරන්න. ඒක තමයි ප්‍රශ්නේ අපිට තියෙන. හිතන්නේ. Right? The item number 9. Where it is? Production cost or distribution or administration or research. Where item number 9? Production. Why? Security guard involving in protecting material, warehouse. Right? You are not locating in direct material cost or direct labor, direct other cost, but you will recognize as another manufacturing overhead. Is that clear? Therefore, whatever the expenses you can place from this point would be production cost. Is that clear? Then whatever the cost you will place in the trade account, cost of sale. Whatever the cost you place under the administration category, administration expenses. Whatever the cost you place under the selling and distribution, then selling and distribution kiya nahi, just distributing cost nahi. Right? That is distribution cost and research, that is a special thing. Right? Okay, let's see other points. 10. Fees to advertising agency. Selling. Salary of scientist in laboratory, research, insurance of company's premises, administration, salary of supervisors working in the factory, production, right? Cost of typewriter ribbons in the general office, administration, protective clothing for machine operatives, production. Engara chine corona case ekak hindara amuthu endun daan inne. E wage amuthu endun daan weda karanawana. So production cost. Is that clear? Right. Now just take this point. This is another method of classifying production and period cost. Some cost will incur on the production, some cost will be incurred on the period, right? The distinction between production and period cost is basis of valuing inventory. Here, production cost are all the cost involved in the manufacturing of good. In case of manufactured goods, these costs consist of direct material, direct labor and manufacturing overhead. Period costs are taken directly to the statement of profit and loss as expenses in the period. Therefore, production manufacturing account present you manufacturing cost, selling and distribution shows you the period cost. Administration expenses or sales expenses incurred during the year. Is that clear? Even you produce or not, entire administration will be charged for the entire 12 months in the P&L. But manufacturing accounts takes only the cost incurred on the production. Clear? Therefore, the period cost are selling and administration expenses. Clear? Ekkene puthe kiyanne profit and loss account for the period ended. For the period ended. Look at the wording we are using. Clear? Right. Then let's move into the behavior. Behavioral cost classification. Fixed, variable and semi-variable. Fixed and variable, you know. Fixed is not change with the number of units. Variable means vary with the number of units. What is semi-variable? What is semi-variable? It will fixed up to some extent. Thereafter will increase. Again it will fix. Thereafter it will increase. Example, when you are producing or when you are running machineries with electricity, even you use or not electricity, you have a fixed bill per month. Thereafter you will have variable cost based on the usage. Am I correct? In your house also same. In your home, water and electricity is a semi-variable. Am I correct? Telephone also semi-variable, right? Clear? Now, the different telephone companies telling, charge 100 rupees and get 1000 minutes and 10,000 SMS. Maruni, illi venakan gaana. Ema kiyanone? However, when you are exceeding more than 1000 minutes or 10,000 SMS, you can have additional cost. Those are called semi-variable. Exactly. That's depend according to the organization. Clear? Examples of fixed and variable cost. Now, direct material costs are variable. Direct labor are variable. Sales commission is often a fixed percentage on sale turnover. And so is a variable. Sales commission, say per unit 1 rupee will pay, variable. If it is 2 rupee, you have to pay 2 rupees, 2 units. If it is 10 units, you have to pay 10 rupees. When the sales commission announces on number of unit basis, is a variable. If sales commission added on the salary as part of the basic salary, it is fixed. Even you sell or not, you will receive it. Exactly. Therefore, directly you can't say sales commission is variable. That's depend how they are providing. Clear? If the commission announced on unit basis or number of working hours basis, it's a variable, right? But if it is announced on as a percentage of the basic salary, if the basic salary is a monthly salary, fixed salary, the commission also a fixed commission. Telephone call charges are likely to increase if the volume of business expands, but there is also a fixed element. Clear? As I told you. Therefore, telephone may be semi-fixed or semi-variable. Up to some extent, you have a common value. Thereafter, it will increase. The rental cost of a business remains constant within the capacity. Therefore, it is fixed. Got it? This is the behavior of the fixed cost. I think you can just understand, because with the number of unit, it remains constant. Then variable cost, this is semi, this called step cost, that is semi variable, remain constant up to some volume, then increase, again remain constant, then increase, step cost behavior. Then the variable cost, when the quantity is increasing, value will increase, right? These are the different behaviors. Some cost will change like this. With the quantity, it will increase. When it's come to specific level, cost will decrease and then it's starting to increase on that level. Why this drop arise? Economic of scale. Ready? Oh, government will tell you, if you produce more than 1,000, we will give you a subsidy of 2 rupees. Until you produce 1,000, you have the original cost. Thereafter, you will start to receive the subsidy of 2 rupees, then your production cost will reduce by 2. Is that clear? Those are the reasons, right? Just refer and try to understand. Examples, electricity, salesperson salary, right? I will recruit you for 15,000 rupees. Thereafter, I will increase your salary based on the number of units you sell. It's a semi variable. Even you work or not, you will receive 15,000. Thereafter, your salary will increase with the number of products you sell. Clear? Then, cost of running a car, fixed cost. Road taxes or insurance, variable, petrol, oil and other, right? They're just examples. These are studies, don't worry. You can download and read this, right? It is available in the website. Let's take this example. I have included MCQ questions for this area, right? Once I complete the important areas, I will move into the MCQs. Cost behavior and activity level. Hans Brach has a fleet of company cars for sales representative. Understood? Badu ikuna nena kattina sales representatives la. Elata car deela thiyena. Hari? Running cost have been estimated as follows. Car cost 1.2 million. When new and have a guaranteed trade in value 600,000 at the end of the 2 years. That is residual value after 2 years. Depreciation is charged on a straight line basis. Then what is the annual depreciation? Residual value after 2 years, 600,000. Cost 1.2 million. Therefore, depreciable value is 600,000. Divide by 2 years, 300,000 per annum is the depreciation. Is it a fixed or variable or semi variable? You have to decide. Got it? Clear? Petrol and oil, rupees 15 per kilometer. If you run 2 kilometers, you have 30, 10 kilometers, 150, 1000 kilometers, you have 15,000 rupees. Will change with the number of kilometers. Tire cost 30,000 per set, replace occur after 30,000 kilometers. Until you run 30,000 kilometers, it is fixed, thereafter it will increase. Clear? routine maintenance cost 20,000 per car per annum in the first year, and the second year it is 45,000 maintenance cost. Repair average 40,000 per car over 2 years, and are thought to vary with distance travel. Average car travel 25,000 kilogram, sorry, kilometers, right? Tax, insurance, membership of motor organizations, that registration fees and insurance and revenue license, everything 40,000, right? Required. Calculate average cost per annum of a cars which travel 15,000 kilometers per annum and 30,000 kilometers per annum. Just write down the question. What you need to calculate? Calculate average cost per annum. Calculate average cost per annum calculate average cost per annum when it's travel per car, right? 15,000 and 30,000 kilometers per annum. Two questions. Got it? Okay. No need the answer. We need the question, right? Two questions, right? If car run 15,000 kilometers, what is the average cost per annum per car, right? If it is run 30,000, what is? I will give you 5 minutes. Try to do that. Right. The number one, what do you need to do? They are asking what is the average cost per car if it is running 15,000 kilometers or 30,000 kilometers. Even you run 1 kilometer or 100,000 kilometers, some costs are fixed, will not change with the number of kilometers. Directly you can take those expenses as it is. That means there are some fixed cost, there are some variable cost. Number one step, you need to classify in between fixed and variable. Otherwise, you can't have answer. You don't have way out. What we have to do first? First, classify in between fixed and variable. Okay, let's classify the car cost. It's a capital expenditure, but you have the depreciation per annum 300,000. Agreed? How do you know how calculated the 300,000, right? Cost minus scrap value, not scrap, residual value, divided by 2, 300,000. It's a fixed or variable. Even you run 15,000 or 13,000 or 0, you have a depreciation of 300,000 per annum. It's a fixed cost. Write down. Now, what you need to do? You have to classify in between fixed and variable. Depreciation, 300,000 per annum, fixed cost, right? Petrol, oil, cost 15,000 per kilometer, variable. If it is 15 rupees per kilometer, if it is 15,000 kilometers into 15,000, if it is 30,000 kilometers, it is into 30,000. Is that clear? That's a variable cost, right? Now, don't multiply it by 15,000 or 30,000. Just write down variable cost per kilometer, oil and petrol. How much? Rupees per kilometer. Tire cost, 30,000 per set to replace after 30 kilometers. If you run only 15,000, you will be ended with the first tire set. But if you run 30,000 kilometers, you have to include two tire sets. Got it? If it is only 15,000 kilometers, because from the tire set you can run 30,000 kilometers. Therefore, under the 15,000 category, your cost is 30,000. But under the 30,000 category, cost will be 60,000. Is that clear? Routine maintenance cost 20,000 per car in the first year. That is fixed. Second year, 40,000. It's a fixed cost per annum. Repair average 40,000 per car over 2 years. Although it vary with distance travelled. The average car travel 25,000 kilometers per annum. The repair cost will be 40,000. It has to be incurred within 25,000 kilometers. Until you run 25,000 kilometers, your cost will be 40,000. But when you exceed it, you have to do another repair. Is that clear? Therefore, under the 15,000 category, only one time. But other category, the 30,000 category, you have two times. Tax insurance membership per annum is a fixed cost. 40,000. Got it? This is the classification. Fixed cost. Depreciation is fixed. Routine maintenance 20,000 for the first year, 45,000 for the second year. Clear? That is the total. Then average per annum 32,500. Tax insurance fixed 40,000. Variable cost, petrol and repair. Clear? Why repair 40,000? See the repair cost, 40,000 per car over 2 years. And taught to vary with distance travel. The average car travel 25,000 kilometers per annum. Is that clear? Then 40,000 rupees
over 2 years, is that clear? Over 2 years, the average car travel 25,000 kilometers per annum. But this 40,000 for 2 years, is that clear? Average running per annum 25,000. 40,000 for 2 years, therefore 40,000 should be divided by 50,000 kilometers. Got it? 40,000 for how many period? 2 years. What is the average running per annum? Therone dudin balan giyan wade awul kiyala. Oka puthe parana study pack ekak gananne. Me wala parana ek karala awana. Parana ke example tikamai thiyen. Maths tika aran maths ekata dala thiyena. Question tika aran mekata dala thiyena. Api maths ekeng podi chance ekak hambala ne. Pai chance hambuna. Inda palaweni wate gehuwena dewini wate indan gahanne ne. ඒකට බඩු හම්බ වෙනවා ඩිජිටල් බිස්නස් කියන එකෙන් නේ. එහෙම නේද? ඒක කරන්න ඕනද? ඒක කරන්න ඕනද? හොඳයි ඔයාලට පුරුදු දෙන්නේ. ඇයි? දවසේ පැය 24 න් පැය 16ක් විතර ගත වෙන්නේ මොකක් එක්කද? ඩිජිටල් එන්වයර්න්මන්ට් එකේනේ ඔයාලා ඉන්නේ. Right? You know everything because you have a smartphone know everything නේ. Right? Entire friends, relative, relations, everything within the phone. You are digitalizing every day, every moment. I think it is an easy subject for you. Don't worry. Right? Okay. 40,000 rupees for 2 years. Average running per annum 25,000 means 2 years 50,000. Therefore, per kilometer, you have to divide 40,000 by 50,000. Clear? Then variable cost 15.8, fixed cost 372.5. This will be take as it is. This will be multiplied by 15,000 kilometers for the first question, 30,000 kilometers for the second question. Is that clear? Got it? Here, 372.5 is the fixed cost, same in both here. Here, 15.8 multiplied by 15, here multiplied by 30. I told you the first tire set is enough for the first year. Because when you are running 15,000 kilometers, no need to replace the tires. Clear? But when you are running 30,000, you have to replace the tires. Then why here 0 and why here 15? When you are running only 15,000 kilometers, Pute, tell me, when the seller, Toyota selling the car, they are selling the car with the tires or without the tires? Therna neda man kiyanne. They are selling the car with the tires neda. Nathuwa tire naha car ekak kadan. Mr. Suraj was purchased what's called, actually I am not familiar with that brand because he is very interesting on that car. BMW i8 neda. He was purchased it, right? Now eya genave kare tiyanne me car ekak. Because it was sold with tires, Nezuraj. Am I correct? Right? Tires ekka ekka vikunne. Etakota when you running only 15,000 kilometers, you can use the original tires you receive, right? Without cost. It has to be replaced after 25,000 kilometers or whatever according to the question. That means under the 30,000 category, you have to replace the tire and only one time. Clear? But I think Suraj will run 100,000 kilometers with BMW i10. Right? Therefore, in the first category, 15,000 category, no cost. Correct? But second category, you want to replace since you are running 30,000 kilometers, you have one time cost. Is that clear? If company is selling the car without the tires, you have 15,000 here also. Clear? We will assume car sellers will sell the car with the tires, right? That is the general knowledge, not costing, right? If you need further classification, you can contact Suraj and ask, right? Okay, let's this example. Identify whether following are likely to be fixed, variable or mixed. Telephone bill, it is variable, sometime variable, sometime fixed, therefore it is a mixed cost. Got it? Annual salary of the chief accountant, fixed. Ethani accountant adal nadi badu adunu adan adda kini ke? Mini accountant itu lagi laptop kak tiaga ni Excel lagi account sahaja jadi no ni. Enak ya uat dah ni. Apa itu tenno kita mah? Right. Therefore it is a fixed cost. Clear? The accountant's annual membership fee to CA Sri Lanka. Dah mah gimana leh tenno? You have this type of membership fee. Currently I think it is nearly wow. Are you also not yet paid? Right? Nearly 15,000 or 20,000 per annum. Is it a fixed or variable? Fixed. That is another answer. Number 4. Cost of material used to pack 20 units of product X boxes. Variable. Number of boxes will increase with the units. Wage of warehouseman, nice word, ne? Warehouseman, what is it? Wage of warehouseman, it is changing, why? Warehouseman kya nikau dhu dhe? Stokeeping? Why it is variable then? The answer is variable. Yeah. If it is a storekeeper's salary, it is fixed, right? Even you stores or not, you have to pay his salary. No? The person who handling, moving item here and there, right? They will be paid based on the number of units they handled. Clear? Nikang ini kan pito kudu bela. Go please go to that. Suraj kau hendak risir apa yang ada kiri? Manim market. Helulu kah dah helulu market tegat ini. Dambul lengi hemmi helulu ini. Hari manim market tegat ya. Hari. Eke orang dah kini mati ada. Inno khati kerat tu la baru tiaga. Aing 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 kikian ni. Alah kikian wacan ni kawacan ni dausan mungkin aing 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 kelekeh parah clear kerja kan. Hari. Ia lagi ngan de, Inggris yang ngan de pa, Tamil lan Tamil lagi ngan, Singal lan Singal lagi ngan, nari de, Inggris dah ngan tu aja de, kau mau tu padi ambil ni, mantri padi aku ambil ni, ni, eh tapi eh ni cak Kelly ngan tu mahat tu kira lagi ni, Kelly kira ni ia lagi badu mutu bag gol tu de, ia lagi tapi eh ni ane badu bag, eh wata me Kelly ngan kira lagi ni, Kelly ngan tu mahat tu kira ni kian, ah that type of person ni, clear, then it's become variable. Right? Now, next classification, relevant and irrelevant cost. But before moving to that, I will take few MCQ questions to have what refreshment. Okay. I have selected few MCQ questions from AZZ and Zima. Let's see. Whether we can answer this type of question at the exam. Now you are in the exam room, right? A cost unit is the cost per hour of operating a machine, the cost per unit of electricity consumed, a unit of product or service in relation to which costs are ascertained, a measure of work output in a standard hour. This question is a very nice question. You can learn a lot of things. Right? Look at the wording given. A cost unit is. When something asks is, he is a boy. You never say he will be a boy. Am I correct?
That's the point you need to learn in English MCQ questions. A yacht cost unit is means they are asking what is the definition. If somebody asks what is it, you have to say this is it, right? That is, you have to define it. Cost unit will be a. Cost unit will be a means they are asking examples. But when they are asking cost unit is, you have to define it. Cost unit, the smallest unit you use to measure the cost. That is the definition. A cost per hour of operating a machine. Yes, it is a cost unit, but it is an example. Got it? A cost per unit of electricity consumed. It is an example. But when the examiner asks cost unit is, next sentence will be the definition. Very sorry, I don't know how to explain in this in Tamil, but I will tell in Sinhala, right? Then you may have, very sorry, right? Because I didn't use that. Now I am trying to learn, right? But still I cannot explain because now I know Tamil, which was learned through Tamil films. One of my Tamil friend told, don't speak this in front of the audience because the films brings you third grade language. එහෙමනම් කියන්න පුළුවන් ෆිල්ම් වලින් ගත්තේ තමිල් යාළුව කිව්වා ඕව නම් කියන්න එපා කියලා චාර්ටර්ඩ් කවුන්ටන්ට් කෙනෙක් විදිහට කියලා. කියන්නේ ෆිල්ම් වල හොඳ ඒවා නෙමෙයි තියෙන්නේ කියලා. හින්දා දැම්ම කියන්න බෑ. හරි? Just ask. Now සිංහලෙන් අහද්දි මේම නෑනේ පුතේ. පිරිවැය ඒකකයක් නිර්වචනය කරන්නේ කිව්වම නිර්වචනනේ අහන්නේ. නේද? නැත්නම් පිරිවැය ඒකකයක් යනු කිව්වම නිර්වචන කරන්න යන්නේ. එක සිංහලෙන් කරද්දි ඕක හරි තමිල් වලින් යද්දි ලේසි. Got it? ප්‍රශ්නත් වෙනවනේ ඉංග්‍රීසි වල ප්‍රශ්නත් තියෙනවා. Therefore you need to understand the way of that's why I'm trying to do questions. Now here they are asking what is the definition? What is කිව්වම what is කියන්නේ they are asking the definition. Is කියන එකෙන් එන්නේ they are asking the definition. He is a boy. Directly you have to say not the examples. He will be a boy කියන්නේ නැහැ. Sometimes we have to say now in Sri Lanka. But generally, right? What is? Asking the definition. Where is the definition here? A, B, C, D, O, A, B, C, O, D. C. The lowest unit. You are measuring the cost. The unit of product or service in relation to which cost are ascertained. Clear? So, make it clear. The way of asking questions. I will tell you another important point. I think it is very important before moving to the questions. See this way. Now, actually, I am not an English lecturer, right? I just learn English by the usage, not the books and CDs, right? Simply, if I tell you, I fail A level English. My A level result is A3 is and 1F. Right, but I learn it through the usage. See this simple sentence. I will take a simple example based on the costing. Say the same example we passed, the security personnel security salary in the warehouse, right? The salary of the warehouse security person, right? Salary of the warehouse security person, then balance part of the sentence. You can write down in different ways. Will be charged. Got it? Or has charged has charged or had been charged.
Can you understand what I am going to tell you? The salary generally will charge into cost of production. Is that clear? Okay. See, will be charged means it will be happen in future. No issue. Has charged. That say was charged, right? Was charged. What is was charged? This will be happen in future, right? Then based on that you have to decide the question. Was charged means it was happen in the past. Clear? Is charged. What is this? Has been charged. It was charged to production cost. Still charged into the production cost. That's why you are saying has been. If you say had been, it was charged, but not now. It was happened there, but not now. Had been charged. See? Has been charged means it was happened. Still it is happening. See? This is the important thing. What is this? Is charged. Is charged. What is it? What is it I am telling? Because based on this, your meaning of the question will be totally changed. What is charged? Suraj is. Madhveni Suraj. Suraj Vendival man dan nahi kai. Suraj is hacked. Was hacked ki ene kai, is hacked ki ene kai vensa mokad. Is ki ene kai tekka past tense ene pute to explain the general practice. Got it? Mehmai venne ki ane. I will tell you now average practice. Once you made the order, this is costing question. Once you made the order from the purchase department, supplier will take time to deliver goods to the stores. The evidence of receiving good is the dispatch note. Evidence of asking good, ordering cost is the purchase order, but generally order process is started with the stores from PRN. Therefore, the PRN date and the dispatch date, there is a gap. That's gap called in inventory management. What is? Lead time. Got it? Costing only example ganna lead time. The time gap between the PRN date and why I am taking this? Because in your auditing paper you have procurement management. The date of PRN is the date you requested. Date of dispatch is the not the date of dispatch, date of you acknowledge the dispatch is the date you received the goods. The time gap called lead time. That is depend on the supplier you selected. Clear? Supplier was delivered within 2 weeks. 2 weeks. Was delivered. It was happened. Supplier is delivered within 2 weeks. What is it? When you take that lead time, you have maximum lead time, minimum lead time, and average lead time. Supplier is delivered within 2 weeks. What is it? Average lead time. Hey, I told you, is charge is talking about the general thing, average thing. Now, if examiner asks you that supplier is delivered, let's talk about the
average practice that need to be taken as the average lead time. Worst delivered means the actual lead time. Will be delivered, right? Maximum within 2 weeks, the maximum lead time. Generally will be delivered, average lead time. Is delivered, average lead time. Without knowing these things, you cannot answer the question. Got it? Because in this question, Suraj, the question number one, a question is they are asking the definition, therefore answer is C. Got it? Second, a cost center is, again they are asking the, they are asking the example or definition. Definition. The cost center is a unit of product or service in relation to which costs are ascertained. That is cost unit, not cost center. Therefore, this is not the definition. This is the definition of cost unit. We need the cost center. An amount of expenditure attribute to an activity. That is not a cost center. Amount of expenditure is not a center. A production or service location, function, activity or item of equipment for which costs are accumulated. A center for which an individual budget is drawn up. What is the answer? C. Because they are asking is. Got it? Third question. Which of the following item might be a suitable cost unit within the accounts payable department of a company? Now they are asking examples for a specific department. Which of the following items, items not slash s. If item slash s kyanne, maybe a one answer or two, three answers. Now they are asking items. Since question is items, right? You should have more than one. Is that clear? Right. Might be a suitable cost unit. Might be a suitable. Now question number one was definition of cost unit. Now they are see whether you have that knowledge of the definition. Is that clear? What is the suitable cost unit within the accounts payable department of a company? Postage cost, invoice process cost, or postage cost or invoice process or supplier accounts. What is it? Accounts payable department means those who are handling suppliers ledger, right? Suppliers ledger. Then what is the minimum unit you can measure the cost? Postage cost, invoice processed, or supply account. Or all three. Amaru ne pute paper. Oy mula prashna ne ba. Process costing, batch costing, hari. Marginal costing, absorption costing, standard costing, variance analysis, budgeting, short term decision making, long term decision making, inventory management. I am referring your syllabus. This is the first two chapters still we have. But eval ACV need. What is the BEP units? Is cost ekata arala damma contribution ne quantity ka kiwa yida kiyala ewa lesi ne puthe mulane beri apita hama ekatama ne mulata tama wedila thiyenne wede ayye api gewal hadanne puthe wahale gahanne gahanne issella wahale patta gahanawa bitti patta gahanawa passe assemble karala onunoth foundation ekata danawa gilenne yaddi me hama ekima therenne mokak dannawada we have not obtained the fundamental knowledge. Am I correct? But don't worry, the complex lessons such as marginal costing, standard costing, variance analysis, budgeting, eva wala taggala kiyena ne ei hadannada tiyenne hitanda ne ne hadanna ekak hadai thin dunnot ne then tell me the answer for this.
Sorry? All of above. You can item 2 and 3. Right, let's see. Second question. Prime cost is. Prime cost is kiyanne mokadda anne? Definition. Prime cost, all cost incurred in manufacturing a product, the total cost, total of direct cost, the material cost of a product, the cost of operating a department. Sorry? B. A. Prime cost is the total, prime cost is all cost incurred in manufacturing, prime cost is the total of direct cost, prime cost is the material cost of a product, prime cost is the cost of operating a department. A name ed? B name ed? B. Banna balum eh? Wala itande paine. Next question. Which of the following cost are part of the prime cost? And now they are asking example. Oka puluwam putte walata ekena wede. Eda man kiyanne. Meka puluwam. Clear? Now here they are asking examples, right? Previously they ask. See how that question developed. This way you will have in this march. Which of the following cost are part of the prime cost for a manufacturing company? Clear? Which of the following cost are part of the prime cost? Cost of transporting raw material from the supplier's premises, wage of factory workers engaged in machine maintenance, depreciation of lorries used for deliveries to customers, cost of indirect production material. What is? Tell me. A? No. A can I? A can I? A can I? English agree. I can hold it. B, C, D. Fill out Hatharadurani Vavisya Adhemet. Right. Next question. Which of the following are direct expenses? Which of the following are direct expenses? The cost of special design, drawing and layout. The hire of tools or equipment for a particular job, salesman wage, rent rates and insurance of a factory. Direct expenses are the expenses will vary with the number of unit. I think number 4 cannot be. Clear? Which of the following are direct expenses? Number 4. Rent, rates and insurance of a factory is not a direct expense. Clear? Ready? Therefore, answer C and D cannot. The answer. Omatama hitan don't put it. There are 50-50 option like I love the better not call a friend than. Ready? Now, these are the things you need to practice at the exam, right? Now, you have four sentences. You definitely know rent rates and insurance, not the direct cost, it's a fixed cost, indirect cost, right? Therefore, it cannot be C or D because both C and D have the number 4. Now, you have 50-50 option you already taken. Now, call a friend. Suraj to call that dealer. Clear? Oh, Suraj to then pull you out of the name of the Uganda. No, I'm not. Normal distribution. I think a graph එක ඇඳලා අර ජනතා විමුක්ති පෙරමුණේ අර මිටිය නැති අනික අනිත් පැත්ත ගැහුවා වගේ බෙල් එක අනිත් පැත්ත ගැහුවා වගේ බෙල් ෂේප් එක තියෙනවානේ ජනතා විමුක්ති පෙරමුණ අනිත් පැත්ත ගැහුවා වගේ හරි දැන් තියෙනවා කාලා ඇඳලා ඔක්කොම ඉරුණාට පස්සේ අහනවා සමීර අර ඔයා කිව්වද මේ පැත්ත 50% මේ පැත්ත 50% ටෝටලිව ඔක 100% කියලා එයා මගෙන් අහනවා Can make it make a hurry to name on Senegomat putti. Palavini level legging and case study and a camera at the Agana Balagino. With a better good nanny, Tanya Quagin in the day. And then make a hagin in only a hen of anica. Pisse could not put a pansalaking in the bow, Masaki, the pieces are even a pirit tailor. ඒ වගේ දැන් එයාට තේරෙනවා. ඒකින්ද එයාටත් ඔක තේරෙන කී අපිට මොන තේරි තිබ්බොත් හරි නෑ. හරි. හරි. මොකද ප්‍රොෆෙෂන් එකේ මාකටිං කරන කෙනෙකුට මේක තේරෙද්දි අපි පොඩි කාලේ ඉඳන් ඉගෙන ගන්න හැට තේරෙන්නේ නැතුන ප්‍රශ්නයක්නේ. Right. Next question. Today you have time to think, right? Different type of questions. නැත්තම් අපි මොකද දැනද කරන්නේ? එල්ලි වෙනකන් ස්ටඩි පැක් එක කියවලා ගොඩක් හදලා පරණ පුරුද්දට එක්සිකියුටිව් ලෙවල් එකේ KE2 කරලා යනවා. එනවා MCQ paper එක. ඉතින් කල්පනා කරන මෙහෙම කරා. You will face this difficulty. Today I'm trying to give you the nature of questions, right? Because this is chapter 1 and 2, not the serious chapters. Which of the following are indirect cost? The depreciation of maintenance equipment. They may be indirect, right? Maybe, I don't know, right? The overtime premium incurred at a specific request of customer. That's a indirect or direct? Indirect, because we have eliminated, remember, that 100 rupees. The hire of a tool for a specific job. That cannot be, because that has been taken especially for the job. If there is no job, you are not getting it. Therefore, it is not direct. It is not indirect. This is direct. Therefore, the answer given with Roman number 3 cannot be the answer. Therefore, again C and D can be eliminated. 50-50 chance. අර ඒ වගේ දෙකක් එන්නේ නැහැ කියලා ලියලා තිබ්බොත් ලකුණු භාගයක් වගේ දෙනවද දන්නේ නැනේ. මට ෂුවර් එකටම A and B ෂුවර් එකෙන් එකක් වා තෝරගන්න කියලා කියන්න පුළුවන්ද? හරි. හරියටම දැම්මොත් දෙකක් දෙනවා. එකෙන් දෙකෙන් එකක් කිව්වොත් භාගයක් දෙන්නේ නැද්ද දන්නේ? එහෙම හදන්න පුළුවන් නම් හොඳයි, ඔක්කොම ක්වොලිෆයිඩ් වෙනවා. A company employs 3 drivers to deliver goods to its customers. What they did? Employed 3 drivers to deliver goods to the customers. The salaries paid to these drivers are a part of the prime cost, direct production expense, production overhead, selling and distribution cost. I don't know. Clear? Today try to imagine. I will take only one question. Ignore it. Now I think you understand what you have to do. No, you not have to do the cram the study text. Always try to understand the rationale behind the each and every theoretical area. Now I will stop the today session. We will meet again tomorrow evening. Clear? What you need to do? I will give you a homework. Tonight, don't do anything. Just read chapter 1 and 2 tonight. What I told you, just read. ඉගෙන ඔයාලා කියවන විදිය නෙමෙයි. පොත මේසේ තියන් ඔළුවේ අද් දෙක ගහගෙන නිදි මරාගෙන මදුරුව මරමර අරව කටපාඩම් කරන එක නෙමෙයි මම මේ කියන්නේ. Just read like you reading a newspaper. Like you watching a television program. Just read what you have to read today. Chapter 1 and chapter 2. If you can do what I am telling this within 10 days, you will be passed. Don't worry. Because we need to understand, not the cram. Because your brain is not the warehouse. Your brain is not a warehouse. Clear? Amase wage nemeyne. Not the stomach. Badata hitanna bae ne puthe. Kawam badagini unama hitana kota bada inna nemena na bada joke ne. Right? Brain eka kiyanne hitana dana. Just read tonight chapter 1 and 2. Just read. Udim balang yanna monawa thiyenne kiyala taduma gane topic tika. Okay. Thank you very much. See you again next evening.